at night, you feel the wind so calm. Assuming a tomorrow so bright, you embellish the innermost charm. As the night enchants its beauty and makes us feel beautiful, it side by side performs her duty by making our night hopeful. Good morning, everyone. Respected Chief Guest, Sri Anil Benke, MLA Belagavi North and State Executive Member, BJP Karnataka. Bishop of Belgaum, Reverend Dr. Derek Fernandez, Manager and Rector, Reverend Father Ronald De Souza, Principal, Reverend Father Dr. Savio Abreu, Vice Principal, Reverend Father Sebastian Pereira, Consultor to the Provincial of the Jesuits, Goa Province, and also the Delegate of the Provincial, Reverend Father Minino Gonzalez, Headmistress of St. Paul's Jesuit School ICSE, Mrs. Lira De Souza, Headmistresses of the three sections of St. Paul's High School, Jesuits and religious dignitaries, benefactors, well-wishers, parents, and my dear teachers. As you all know that St. Paul's High School has been serving the society since the year of its inception, that is from the year 1856. So, to mark its remembrance, we manifested to start a new school, St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, to continue serving and igniting young minds for a greater transformation. The challenges may be new, the instruments with which we meet them may be new, but those values upon which our hard work depends, that is honesty, courage, loyalty, and obedience. These all are what we carry along our way in life. They have been the silent force of progress throughout the history of our school. Today's event is a remarkable celebration of inaugurating the small steps that we have taken towards spreading knowledge. At my lowest, God is my hope. At my darkest, God is my light. At my weakest, God is my strength. At my saddest, God is my comfort. Let us begin today's auspicious event with a praise to our Almighty, the most merciful and benevolent. I solicit Teacher Mary De Costa to lead us in prayer.
Let's take a prayerful posture. What will it profit a man if he gains the whole world and suffers the loss of his soul? These words were the turning point in the life of Saint Ignatius of Loyola, the patron saint of the Jesuits, whose feast day we celebrate today. A new beginning with the introduction of the ICSE syllabus. We thank God for the inspiring minds, toiling hands, and generous hearts that have made this day a reality. We ask God's blessings on this new venture of St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, which is also a turning point in the history of St. Paul's High School. Through the prayers of St. Ignatius of Loyola, may the school help our community and build the kingdom of justice and peace. We pray that St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, continues to shape the lives of youngsters and help them become great human beings and global citizens. May our children learn to grow always in your sight and under your protection. Help us to teach them to stand firm upon convictions, yet be merciful and kind. In unison, we lift our hearts with gratitude. Lord, we ask your abundant blessings on those selfless souls who worked tirelessly during the pandemic to save lives and to meet the needs of the society. With a uniqueness, yes, yet with oneness of heart and mind, may we together make this world a better place to live in. Amen.
Meditation in movement. A walking into silence where every moment becomes prayer. Now I call upon Master Ninad Ashok to perform a prayer dance. Someone else, it will surely brighten your path. I request all the dignitaries to brighten this occasion by lighting the lamp.
Hello, please.
light that is lit take over the darkness and guides us towards the progress of our students. Thank you, everyone. Respect and relations. I now request Sir Xavier Martin to greet everyone present here.
On this auspicious day, we have gathered here today for the inauguration ceremony of St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, a new venture that is initiated by the Jesuits of the Goa province. The journey of St. Paul's High School started in the year 1856. St. Paul's High School has achieved all the success in those golden periods. Today, on the occasion of 500 years of Ignatian anniversary, we all are proud to walk another step ahead to start St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE. It's a significant day for our institution and also a matter of great honor for all the students, teachers, and alumnus. I congratulate each one of those hardworking hands who have truly worked hard to start our new school. I extend a warm welcome and also express my gratitude to each and every one of you for being a part of this prestigious school, that is St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE. I end here by the words well quoted by St. Ignatius of Loyola. May the perfect grace and eternal love of Christ our Lord be our never failing protection and help. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I request our principal and headmistress of St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, to escort the guests onto the dais. To be inspired is great, but to be an inspiration is an honor. I request Teacher Elizabeth Lobo to introduce our dignitaries.
Reverend Dr. Derek Fernandez, Bishop of Belagavi, your presence has made our new school, St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, more blessed and grace-filled. Our hearts are filled with joy by your presence. I request our principal, Reverend Dr. Father Savio Ebreu, to felicitate Reverend Dr. Derek Fernandez, Bishop of Belagavi. Amidst us, our guest of honor, the Deputy Commissioner of Commercial Tax, Sri Chandrakant M. Lokhare, KAS. We are happy to have you, sir, in the journey of our new school as a parent. Thank you, sir, for entrusting your child in our care. We assure you, dear parents, that we'll impart the best values and knowledge to all the children. I request our principal, Reverend Father Dr. Savio Abreu, to felicitate Sri Chandrakant M. Lokhare, the Deputy Commissioner of Commercial Tax. We are indeed privileged to have with us Sri Barjaswar, the Chief Executive Officer of Belagavi Cantonment Board. Thank you so much, sir, for always standing by us and giving all the necessary permission to go ahead with this venture. I request our principal, Reverend Father Dr. Savio Abrin, to felicitate respected Sri Barjaswar. Father, for doing the honors. I request Teacher Sabina Kolkar to kindly take over.
We are indeed privileged to have our rector and manager, Reverend Father Roland D'Souza. I now request our vice principal, Father Sebastian Pereira, to kindly felicitate our rector and manager, Father Roland D'Souza. We are indeed honored to have our principal, Reverend Father Dr. Savio Abio, principal of St. Paul School and St. Paul Jesuit School, ICSE. I request our Vice Principal, Reverend Father Sebastian Pereira, to kindly felicitate our Principal, Reverend Father Dr. Savio Abio. Mrs. Lira D'Souza, headmistress of the St. Paul Jesuit School, ICSE. I request our vice principal, Reverend Father Sebastian Pereira, to felicitate Mrs. Lira D'Souza. I now hand over to Teacher Kirti James.
I deem it an honor to introduce Reverend Father Menino Gonzalez. At present, he is the Superior of Christ Nivas Nesagi, District Coordinator and Province Consultor. He is also the Administrator of three schools, Vidyamandir School Nesagi, Ashram School Mohore, and Ashram School Deshmi. He has been awarded with an honorary doctorate degree by International Global Peace University, Chile. I request Mrs. Lira D'Souza, headmistress of St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, to come forward and felicitate Reverend Father Menino Gonzalez. Fortunate to have in our midst Mr. Manoj Michael, ex-president PBW. I request Mrs. Lira D'Souza, headmistress of St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, to felicitate Mr. Manoj Michael. Dr. Rohit Joshi, present president, PBW. I request Mrs. Leela D'Souza, headmistress of St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, to felicitate Dr. Rohit Joshi. Dr. Anil Patil among our midst. I request Mrs. Leela D'Souza, headmistress of St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, to felicitate Dr. Anil Patil. Time and patience. We feel extremely privileged and honored to see your presence today. If your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more, then you are a leader. Let us have the pleasure to hear the words of a great and inspiring person. I request our Bishop, Dr. Derek Fernandez, to say a few words.
Shriman Lokriji, Shriman Vachaswaji, the CEO of Kandrabin, the dignitaries of the days, and my dear brothers and sisters. After having spoken for more than 20 minutes in the Eucharist, I thought I would be just sitting and going. And then I'm asked to step into the feet or shoes of somebody else, but I'm very happy to do it. Particularly because today I want to congratulate the Jesuits for the bold step that they have taken. Starting this ICSE school amidst lots of difficulties and problems. I don't think anybody else would venture such an adventure during this time of pandemic where everything is at a standstill and financially everybody seems to be broken, but the Jesuits seems to be having a lot. I don't know whom to congratulate, maybe the provincial, Father Savio, Director, Father Roni. Every Jesuit, I would like to congratulate you for this bold step. At the Eucharist, I also said one thing. 500 years ago, when a cannon ball hit a rock and a small piece ricocheted, bones back, and hit the leg of St. Ignatius, he was consigned to his bed. And many would think such an incident in one's life is something very negative and would ask God why it is. But then, believe me, this morning I said there wouldn't have been Jesuit order. And I would like to say if that had not happened, there wouldn't have been St. Paul's ICSE school being open today. Just because St. Ignatius was hit on his leg, today we are having a school day. That reminds me of an incident in the life of a great tennis player, Arthur Ashe. I'm sure most of us have heard about him, and the age that I'm seeing here, I would say that all of us knew or know him as a great Wimbledon champion of the 80s. I'm sure many of you have heard. After he hung his racket, retired from playing tennis, he took up social work. He fought for the rights of the people, and we have now a great hero who died a few days ago, Father Stan Swami. Similar work was done by also Arthur Ashe, and he also went to jail many a times. He had to undergo a bypass. Those days, transfusion from the others, the blood transfusion from the others was done. And after a few years, he was tested positive for HIV. And the world went around saying that he was dying. Many of his fans wrote to him, and among them was a young boy who wrote and said, "Sir Arthur Ashe, I don't know why God had to be so mean to you, why you had to have this disease, why not the others?" Many of the letters were answered by him, and one of them was this letter. And he wrote to that boy, youngster, saying that, "My dear, every year at least 50,000 people decide to start playing tennis. Out of 50,000 people, at least 5,000 buy a racket. Out of 5,000, about 500 actually land up playing actual tennis. And out of this 500, only 50 come to Wimbledon. And only out of 50, only one person holds that shield in his hand as a victor. And that day when I was holding the shield, I never asked God, 'Lord, why me and not the others?' And today when I am suffering, why shall I ask God, 'Lord, why me and not the others?'" And this is the principle involved in what I said at the beginning. St. Ignatius was hit with that shrapnel, and he went out of circulation because his leg was shortened after it was cured, and he decided to take up the work of Christ. Something which everybody thought would destroy his life was in fact an instrument to brighten his life, not only brighten his life, brighten the lives of hundreds and thousands of people down through the 5 centuries. And today, one of the results of that is this particular school which we are inaugurating today. I wish the Jesuits all the best. May this school grow and shine, bear abundant fruit, just as St. Paul's for the past 164 years have brought out many a great stalwarts and great heroes. May this school or new school, the branch of the new school, may also grow and flower and bring out many, many great souls and present them to the society. In that video I heard, or we saw, that the purpose of the school is not only to educate people, but also give quality education and bring out good leaders. May great leaders emerge from this school. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bishop. Your presence and gentle words are a source of encouragement for all of us. Vision without action is a dream, and action with vision is making a positive difference. I request Teacher Ledwina Mendonca to brief us about the Polite Link and also initiate the release of the magazine.
The Polite Link magazine acts as a link between those who have already achieved their goals of their school career and those who are still in the process of achieving. The Polite Link is a beautiful bridge that links both Polites and Josephites in the past and the present. This issue of the Polite Link is dedicated to the new venture, St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE. Today, on this auspicious day of the 500th year of the conversion of St. Ignatius, the Polite Link team found it befitting to release the June 2021 issue of the magazine. May the good Lord continue to bless our sincere and dedicated efforts which the team selflessly gives to our alma mater, St. Paul's High School. Continue to put on the armor of light. And the other dignitaries to release this issue of the Polite Link. I also request the editor, Mr. Shahab Bandukwala, to assist in the release.
Carries God in his heart, bears heaven with him wherever he goes. We have our consultor and our provincial's delegate, Reverend Father Minino Gonzalez, who will now read out the provincial's letter.
My dear friends, now I'm going to read the message which is given by our provincial, Father Roland Coelho. Dear Bishop Derek Fernandez, Father Ronnie, Father Savio, Father Sebi, faculty and staff, distinguished guests, parents, students, alumni of the St. Paul's benefactors, and my dear friends, I congratulate you as you inaugurate the new St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, under the Council of Indian School Certificate Examination, CISCE Board. This is a wonderful step in our mission to uphold the Constitution of India and to offer our brothers and sisters an integral and quality education. You are educating young men and women for life so that they will not become selfish human beings, rather they will seek to generously serve others in India and all over the world. In short, they will become men and women for and with others. The Jesuits have been offering quality education to people all over the world. Over the last 450 years, you will work together to teach them how to competent. You will develop their conscience. You will inspire them to be committed, and you will make them compassionate human beings. With this new school, you are continuing this tradition of excellence. As the Jesuits celebrate the Ignatian year, this is the concrete service to the people of Belagavi, so that our citizens of this beautiful city can live together in peace and harmony. As brothers and sisters, you have my blessings and good wishes for this new temple of learning. Sincerely, Roland Coelho, Provincial. Thank you, one and all.
It's always good to know more about people who are an inspiration for others. I request Teacher Jamma Sungar to do the honors of introducing our chief guest, Sri Anil Menke, MLA Belagavi North and State Executive Member, BJP Karnataka.
A very good afternoon to one and all gathered here. For the inauguration of St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE, I am indeed honored and feel privileged to introduce our honorable chief guest of today's function, Sri Anil Benke, MLA Belagavi North and State Executive Member, BJP Karnataka. Our beloved MLA, Sri Anil Benke, was born and brought up in Belagavi. I'm pleased to know that our MLA, sir, was a cadet of NCC Air Wing and has represented the state twice at the RDC parade at Delhi in the year 1983 and 1984. He has meticulously earned the A, B and C certificate of NCC. He is also a certified glider pilot. An advocate by profession, Sri Anil Benke completed his LLB from RL Law College, Belagavi. He was elected the General Secretary in the year 1990-91. The year the college celebrated its 50 golden years. Sir has 22 years of practice as an advocate and has served as a legal advisor of Belagavi Urban Development Authority from the year 2002 to 2006. A social activist, Sri Anil Benke was also president of Karnataka Kshatriya Maratha Parishad, Belagavi district. Sir has taken active part and tended to many socio-economic related issues. Sir is the ex-president of the BJP Mahanagar Belagavi district. He is also the national advisor to the Kranti Sena Belagavi. Sri Anil Benke is a visionary at par excellence. His pioneering spirit, hard work, and perseverance is the driving force behind the development works undertaken by him related to our city's infrastructure and environmental issues. So, indeed, your achievements and social service to our city and society and our nation at large is innumerable. I thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule and presiding over our function. A special thank you, dear sir, for being a constant support towards starting St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE. I request our rector and manager, Reverend Father Ronnie D'Souza, to kindly do the honors of felicitating our chief guest, Sri Anil Benke, member of the Legislative Assembly, Belagavi.
The pleasure to hear the words of a great and an inspiring leader. I request our chief guest, Sri Anil Benke, MLA Belagavi North and State Executive Member, BJP Karnataka, to say a few words.
First of all, sorry for coming late. Excuse me, because I had been to Bangalore yesterday at night I came. Function of ICSE, St. Paul's School. Present on the dais, Honorable Bishop Rodrigues, all the dignitaries, because they have put a mask. Very difficult to identify. Therefore, all of you should excuse me that also. If I put, nobody will recognize me also. This is the problem. Even though some of the people are there who are not wearing masks, thanks for that. Here I am seeing so many people, all the teachers. Here some parents are not wearing mask. But majority is there who are wearing mask. Because I came from the city, at least 90% persons are not wearing mask. Here, reverse it is. 99% are wearing mask. Therefore, Dhanyavad. And first of all, I congratulate the St. Paul's, all who are responsible for starting this new international level school, especially Honorable Bishopji, all the fathers. I inquire about the persons, the fathers, brothers and sisters were celebrated. And it was occasion to celebrate them because they have put a hard work to bring this school to this level. Therefore, I also, from my heart, I congratulate all the fathers, sisters and the brothers who contributed for the development of this school. Development means, you know the, if you come to my office in the month of May and June, you will find the 100 people. Out of that, 90 people will be waiting for the St. Paul's admission. I think you understood about the development and improvement of the, or the name of the school. Out of that 90, I don't know how much people get the admission from my side. And out of that 90, if I issue letters to all of them, I know how much, if I give 90 students letters and if you give the admission, the what is the necessity to start you, the school? I will be the owner of the school. Out of all students, letters are issued 90, means all students from MLSI. And it should not happen. Because I issue letter to those who comes. And then ball goes to your court. Then you start deciding whether how much MP gives letter, Anil Binti gives letter, so many people give. And all these letters were again kept or thrown, I don't know. And I expect the same thing. Because I cannot be the person to be blamed in future. Because the person who comes, I issue letter. If you give admission to all those, definitely the year result will be, you cannot imagine. Therefore, what you do, I appreciate, I thanks, and since you are strict about the admissions and the procedure and the administration, the school has achieved this popularity not in Belgaum, not in Karnataka, not in India. It is internationally recognized as St. Paul's School of Belgaum. Some of the ex-students have made a group of ex-students of the St. Paul's School. You can find out Near about 25% of the students are out of the country and they are serving international level. All over the world you are having your name from Belagavi St. Paul's School. You can now clap. When I said about the mass, you are clapping fast. But when I should appreciate, because next year also I am going to get so many parents, and I think there are so many parents sitting there, and they might have got letter from me, but they have got admission on merits, not from my letter. My letter is not a merit for the admission. Your child is a merit for the admission. Therefore, again I thanks to St. Paul's all the ex-students, fathers, Honorable Bishop for starting the today's required school. Today's required means आज की दुनिया चांद पर है, हम यहां सो बैठ के चांद पर जा सकते हैं, यहां बैठ के हम हमारे अमेरिका के जो आपके विद्यार्थी उनके साथ बात कर सकते, तो दुनिया छोटी हो गई। तो ऐसी दुनिया के अंदर ऐसा ही स्कूल चलाना चाहिए जो आज आपने बेलगाम के अंदर सेंट पॉल की तरफ से शुरू किया। तो बेलगाम के सभी लोगों की तरफ से जिनकी बहुत इच्छा थी कि बेलगाम में ऐसा स्कूल हो जहां लड़का पढ़े, लड़का या लड़की पढ़े, दुनिया के कहां भी पांव रखने के बाद, कदम रखने के बाद वो स्कूल के जो शिक्षा है उसका इस्तेमाल हो, ऐसी अपेक्षा थी। आपने बेलगाम लोगों की अपेक्षा पूरी की, इसी सेंट पॉल वालों की सबको धन्यवाद। दूसरी चीज ऐसे है, मंजिलें उन्हीं को मिलती है जिनके सपनों में जान होती है, मंजिलें उन्हीं को मिलती है जिनके सपनों में जान होती है। यूं ही पंख होने से कुछ नहीं होता, हौसलों से उड़ान होती है। आपके पास पंख भी है और हौसला भी है, दोनों मिला के आज चल रहे, इसीलिए आप इंटरनेशनली वेल नोन इंस्टीट्यूट है। इसीलिए जो मैंने बात बताई ऐसी ही नहीं है, इसके लिए कुछ तो मेहनत करनी पड़ती है। इसके लिए आप जो लोग इतने दिन से इस स्कूल के लिए मेहनत कर रहे, बेलगाम दो तीन चीज के लिए जाना जाता है, एक मराठा लाइफ इंफेंट्री, दूसरा एयरफोर्स, तीसरा बेलगाम की जनता जो छोटा भारत, तीसरा तो आपका सेंट पॉल स्कूल। तो ये कोई मैं प्रशंसा नहीं कर रहा हूं, क्योंकि इससे पहला चार तीन लोगों का नाम लिया, चौथा नंबर आपका है। पहला नहीं लेता था तो लगता था कि ये कुछ झूठ बोल रहा है, सच है तो ये झूठ बात नहीं, इसीलिए आपका फोर्थ नंबर है तो भी बड़ी बात है। और जो पेरेंट्स लोगों के लिए एक बात है, आज की दुनिया के अंदर एंड विशेष इन बेलगाम देर आर सो मेनी प्रॉब्लम्स रिगार्डिंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड द पेरेंट्स। द मेन प्रॉब्लम इज एंड विच इज डिस्कस्ड इन बेलगाम, गांजा, चरस एंड अदर थिंग्स, एंड बेलगाम इज After Punjab, it is intelligence report. Now, mine, it's not my report. After Punjab, you know Punjab, what has happened. Now, next is number is Belgaum number. And there are so many reasons, because it is the location of the city. It is near to Goa, near to Maharashtra, near to like this. And it is central place for the such an activities. Therefore, parents should be very careful. parents have to involve in the education of the child. If you involve in the education of the child will remain in the school for the education purpose, and parents are the first teacher and school is the, or the teachers are the second teacher. Therefore, the parents are responsible for the development of the child, shaping of the life of the child, and hence, when you got admission in the St. Paul school, you forget about his character. आप सब टीचर के ऊपर छोड़ देते सिंपल स्कूल मुगित बीड झालं काम आमचा मुलगा शिकला संपला गेला पुढे दिस इज हॅपनिंग सेंट जोसेफ टीचर्स आर देअर सेम प्रॉब्लम 90 पीपल 90 हियर 90 हियर अँड यू माइट हॅव गॉट दिस मच ऑफ लेटर्स अनिल बेनके साईन सेंट टू Change the school. Therefore, you are also included in this fourth number. Fourth number, it may go up because earlier the people who used to go to English medium to other school also now shifted to St. Joseph school. They want admission in the St. Joseph school. They want admission in the St. Paul's only. This is the problem. This is not a problem, sorry. Otherwise you will say, what is problem? No problem. This is the image created by you. This is the reason. Because you have created the students international level, and therefore the people want the admission in your school. It is not my reason. It is the people who appreciate about your work. Therefore, parents have to take the care of the child. I failed in second year. वाय मंजिले उन्हीं को होती है जिनके सपनों में जान होती है यार ऐसा क्यों बताया बोले तो मेरी तरफ से देख के बताया सेकेंड ईयर आई फेल्ड देन आई यू रेड अबाउट माय बायोडाटा इट इज लॉन्ग बैक बायोडाटा नॉट फ्रेश The PA should be one step ahead. चाय से ज्यादा गरम किटली होनी चाहिए तो हमारी किटली ठंडी है चाय गरम है मैं खुद गरम हूं दे आई वेंट टू रिपब्लिक डे परेड इन द फर्स्ट ईयर टू थ्री मंथ्स ट्रेनिंग गोइंग टू बेंगलोर देर फ्रॉम दिल्ली देर आई टुक पार्ट इन द Republic Day parade, and when I came, they failed. Then I requested. This is the position I was in Delhi for two months in Bangalore. I think you are also well known because from your DP school, St. Joseph and St. Paul's, maximum students go to Delhi from these three schools. Yeah. And one more is Saini school from Chittoor. I know. Because three, four schools are there, maximum they participate in the Republic Day parade. Therefore, I know very well. And they failed. Then again, Dhakulun pass, Marathi. Means promoted. I was promoted in the second year. And therefore, I am talking with the parents. Bachcha fail hua to usko darao mat. मेरे जैसा कभी भी एमएलए हो सकता है तो जानिए उसके अंदर क्या ज्ञान है वो क्या कर सकता है 100% मार्क लेने से कोई बड़ा नहीं होता है नहीं तो ऐसा ना हो जाए कि आप पढ़ाई बंद कर दें चलो आप तो अभ्यास बंद मोड़ो एमएलए आते हो बरोबर आहे अभ्यास होण्याचं नापास व्हायचं एम एल ए व्हायचं असं काय ते डोक्यात घेऊन का नाही त्याच्यात की काय सांगून गेला बिनके आणि काय झालं हो असं म्हणलं बरोबर आहे त्यामुळे मुलांची काळजी घ्या त्याला मस्त तुम्ही खेळायला द्या अभ्यास करू देत मोठा होऊ देत व्यसनापासून दूर ठेवा यू शुड बी अवे फ्रॉम दी ऑल दीज बॅड हॅबिट्स दिस इज द ओनली रिझन द पर्सन कॅनॉट रीच टू हिज ॲम्बिशियस प्लेस Therefore, again, without taking your more time, thanking for calling me here. Honorable Bishop knows me. I went to his office. I met him. I discussed about the development of the churches. And he knows very well. I don't want to talk now this. Even though in coming days, we'll see that all the churches will be developed as per your wish. Surrounding area of the churches will be developed as per your wish. I have met to the Honorable Bishop also regarding this. We are to that level to sanction the fund from the government. It is my duty, it is my pleasure to do these things. Thank you very much.
Appreciation is the highest form of prayer, for it acknowledges the presence of good. Wherever you shine the light of your thankful thoughts. It's time now to acknowledge, appreciate and felicitate who have helped in starting our new school. We are indebtedly grateful to Reverend Father Pius Fernandez and Mrs. Jayanti Sheshadri for being the pioneers to start this new venture. They have been guiding us right from the inception of starting St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE. We have many precious hands which have come together to start this new school.
Thank you, teacher. The person who has consumed himself to serve the society and light the darkness in the life of our children, it's none other than our principal, Reverend Father Dr. Savio Abreu. I request Father to share his experiences of starting our new school.
Respected guests on the dais, Sri Anil Benke, Mr. Chandrakant Lokre, Mr. Barcheswa, Honorable Bishop Derek Fernandez, Father Menino Gonsalves, Father Ronnie, Teacher Lira, the headmistress of St. Paul Jesuit School, Manoj Michael, Dr. Anil Patil and Dr. Joshi. And my dear friends, it is actually a great privilege for me to stand here before you. Last year when I came here, I just came last year, this is just my second year, beginning of my second year, I never thought I would be standing here and we would be inaugurating a new school, because normally when you come in, it takes time for you just to get settled. And yet to start this, and especially in this beautiful place, I'm sure many of you are surprised when you see this, because this was more of a wasteland, hardly used. Since I came here, I've never seen this place being used. And I think it's a beautiful occasion that we have, where we are starting this new school. I do not want to speak long. I've said everything in the video, which you have watched in the beginning. But I think what I would like to do is two things, or two sentiments. I would like to express two sentiments that are foremost in my mind. One is the sentiment of gratitude, and the second is the sentiment of fulfillment. These are two things that I would like to express. When I look back, and I think that was the theme we had for the Eucharist, the theme which I had suggested, looking backward to move forward. Now, because for me, that is what my journey here also has been. That when I came here, I may have been new in St. Paul's, but St. Paul's has a legacy of more than 160 years. So I was not without a past, without a history. And while I do lecture history to the 10th standard students, I take history, I'm not a historian. Though I've been at the Xavier Center of Historical Research for 13 years. So in a way, I have been in historical research. And yet I'm not a historian because my field is sociology. But history is very important for us. And therefore we cannot look forward till we look backwards. If we want to move forward, we need to look first backward. And for me, I think that is what I would like to do. So first and foremost, this sense of gratitude that I have, gratitude that so many people who have come before me, whether it was Father Agnello, Father Jacob, Father Rajendra, Father Jerry, Father Roland, Father Basil, Father Pedro, all these principals who came before, and many others, I'm just taking a few names who have been there in the last few years, these have built up the school. So as the Honorable MLA said, if so many go to him for admission, and I can understand his work is difficult, and he makes our work more difficult by sending all those letters, because then we have to, you know, look at all those letters, and we wonder from the MP, from him, from the other MLA, Abhay, and it goes on. We have a long list from Deputy CM, and it goes on. We keep getting, almost even yesterday, I got a letter from the Deputy CM. And so it goes on. Every day there are letters on my desk. And I think it's because of this legacy, the legacy of the past, that all these Jesuits have built up. They have, through their hard work, through their tireless activity, they have built up this school. And therefore I would like to really be grateful today and remember them for all that they have done. If today we are able to start this new school, and this new school is definitely not just my venture, though I may be the person here who is starting it, but it is the culmination of that journey. It's a long journey that we have had, and therefore my second sentiment that I mentioned, a sentiment of fulfillment. I feel a sense of fulfillment today that what over the last 1 year we have been running about, you know, trying to get permissions, trying to find out different things, it, besides the schoolwork, all this has been extra work and it has definitely not been an easy task. But I think you feel a sense of fulfillment today that yes, we have been able to achieve it, we have been able to start the school. One point I would like to mention here in my journey, I was here at St. Paul's in 1998, many years back now. At that time, I was in this hostel building here, you can see just behind you, for 2 years. I was in charge of the hostel. And when I look at the Society of Belgaum at that time, and the Society of Belgaum today, many things have changed. I think the Honorable MLA also mentioned about how the aspirations of the people have changed. Earlier, Belgaum was a very, you know, small, sleepy town. It had, you know, very few things in it. It was always known for education, but besides that, there was nothing much. Today, things have changed. It has become more of a bustling city. And the aspirations of the people are, they don't want their children just to study here and get a job in Udyambag or, you know, in any of these places. But they want their children to go to other parts of the world. That is something I see a major change from when I was here in 98 to today. And having seen it in the last 1 year that I came, I realized we need to, as educationists, we need to fulfill that aspirations of the people. And one of the way that we could fulfill it was by starting this. As Sri Anil Benke mentioned, when we look at what we have existing here, we have a lot of state board schools. We have a lot of CBSE schools under the central board. But we hardly have any good ICSE schools. In fact, there are just two schools now at present in Belgaum which are under the ICSE. But if you look at Bangalore, you look at Bombay, you look at Delhi, there are hundreds of ICSE schools. In fact, Bangalore has almost, I think, 150 to 200 ICSE schools. So that is the difference. The aspirations of the people in the big city and the aspirations of people in a smaller town or a smaller city like Belagavi. But I think that is changing. And I feel this school will be the catalyst for that change. This school will bring about that change. That with this type of an ICSE school, many more schools will mushroom. And that is my dream. Surely St. Paul's will be there, but I feel many more schools will come up under the ICSE board. And in a few years, we will have people getting a good choice for high quality education. I think every parent, and now even in among our parents, we have people from different backgrounds, people who have themselves not studied and yet they want education in the ICSE school. And we have among the parents here some of them who themselves have maybe just SSE background, but now they want their children to study in an ICSE school so that they can go to any part of the world. You know, it is like you get wings, you are able to fly. But if we, at present, from what we had, it was more that they would be stuck here. It is true that St. Paul's has this rich legacy, and we have seen it in the video, and that's what I mentioned, that all those students who have passed out from here have gone to different parts of the world. Sri Anil Benke mentioned that, and I think that's a matter of pride for us, that due to the hard work, due to the commitment of the teachers, the staff that we have had over the years, the Jesuits that we have had, I think that has brought about this change. That many of our students, our alumni, are in different parts of the world doing well. That is a tribute to our teachers, to our students. Let's give them a round of applause.
Hello.
And finally, the culmination of my journey, I mentioned the sense of fulfillment. It's a sense of fulfillment because in the short span of 1 year, we were able to do many things. And here I would like to just take the name of two people. One is my assistant, Father Sebi, who is the vice principal of the school. He has been a very strong pillar of support for me. If not for him, we would not have been able to probably have this inauguration. And the other person I would like to mention is teacher Lira. Okay. So, another person who had this idea, who had the vision, who was able to support us, and because of which in a short time, in just this few months, we have been able to come to this juncture where we are able to inaugurate this new school. In fact, many people were telling me when we were starting, you are too much in a hurry. Wait for some more time. Start next year. You know, there was a lot of suggestions came. But I always remember, and for me that inspiration comes, St. Francis Xavier. St. Francis Xavier is known as a saint in a hurry. Because he was a person in just 11 years. 11 years he was in this part of the world. He has gone to most of, you know, India, Asia, Japan, all those places, China. Everywhere he was, and in those days when there was no proper transport, nothing, he was able to go to all these places in just those 11 years. I think he was definitely a saint in a hurry. And for me, that is my inspiration. And so finally, as I said, a sense of gratitude. I'm very grateful for all the dignitaries for coming today for this beautiful function that we have had. I'm also grateful to everyone who has chipped in their best. We have tried to felicitate as many people, but I'm sure there are many more whom probably we could not, because we in fact, when we are making the list, we said, if we call everyone to felicitate, till evening we will be here, you know. So therefore, there are many others who have put in a lot of effort. I would like to thank all of them. And I look forward, I think I ended that in my video also. I am of the firm belief that this school in a few years' time is going to rank as one of the best ICSE schools in the country. Once again, I'd like to thank everyone for this occasion. And I'm sure that together we can take this school forward. I thank the parents. You all have put your trust, you have entrusted your children in our care. We will definitely not disappoint you. And I'm sure that together we will be able to, you know, bring up this school and give the best education to your children. Thank you very much.
Mrs. Valina Gonsalves and Ms. Stacy Saunders to kindly come on the dais. Mrs. Valina Gonsalves and Ms. Stacy Saunders are the staff members of St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE. I request the headmistress, Mrs. Lira D'Souza, to kindly do the honors.
Mrs. Nandini Pai, headmistress of St. Paul's High School. Ms. Liberia Swami, headmistress of St. Paul's Primary School. Mrs. Rufa Chadichal, headmistress of St. Paul's Sunbeam Nursery. Dr. Padmini Ravindran, principal of St. Paul's PU College. Every young child who believes in himself is a parent who believed first. I request Mr. Chandrakant Lokre, Deputy Commissioner State GST Belagavi, to say a few words on this occasion.
Chief Guest of the Press Commission, Sri Anil Mendesar, Principal of the St. Paul's, Reverend Father Sally Abdul, Vice Principal, Reverend Father Sebastian Ferreira, Headmistress, Ms. Lira D'Souza, Reverend Father Gonsalves, Josie Ji, Manoj Ji, Dr. Anil Patil Ji, all the fathers of the dais, and all the sisters of the dais, and my dear friends. It gives me an immense pleasure to be here on this auspicious and holy occasion of marking 500 years of Ignatius of Loyola. And this is a day, on this day, holy day, you are taking a venture by laying edifice to the course of ICSE. I was observing a documentary, just I found. So 160 years history, how the Jesuits have toiled themselves to bring this institution to this international recognition. Really, hats up to them. I salute them. Actually, this institution has been started, and when I getting the admission, I am very grateful and very lucky to get my admission for my kid to this institution for LK. That is ICSE. When I was getting the admission, there was a lot of apprehensions among the parents that so this is such a difficult syllabus, such a tough syllabus, it will be, it will at international level, everything and all. So nothing is like that. It is as simple as you have to make it simple. The parent is responsible to a parent to make it simple. Right? So it is a need of the hour. Today is a world is so vibrant, so competitive. We need to cope up with the situation, circumstances, right? So everywhere there is a race, man's race to win. Win-win situation is there. In such a circumstances, the institutions like ICSE and that too, handled by St. Paul's like Jesuit institutions is a great thing. And definitely it is going to have this day is going to have a milestone in the annals of St. Paul's history. So this is one thing. Second thing, I know you have witnessed the pandemic. You have seen two pandemics, first one, second one. How it has made the havoc, especially the second pandemic. Many lakhs of people lost their lives. Lakhs of people lost their daily bread earners, nearly 1.26 kids, children, they become orphans. They lost their caretakers, either fathers or mothers or caretakers. So this is how it has created the pandemic. So it is the time to reset our lives, to adjust to the situations, circumstances. It is said that experts are opining that third wave is going to come hit by third week of August. we should be prepared. And that too, they are saying that it is going to affect the children and kids. So therefore, we have to be prepared to face any kind of eventualities. Whatever comes, let us be prepared and adjust to the situation. Try to learn with the situations, right? So there are so many things we have to teach the kids, the behavior, social behaviors, whatever the required behaviors to handle the pandemics, right? So give them nutritious foods, give them immune kind of things, teach them social behaviors, always keep them active. So this pandemic has taught us a lot. So it has created a revolution in the technological field. So now we were unaware of all these things. We were unaware of live performances, live events, live classes. Now children are used to it. They are feeling it is more effective than going to the schools. Even infrastructure, everything is being saved. The money is saved, school fees are saved. So all these things are there. But we have to be prepared. We should not lose our hearts. And this is my appeal for all the parents here. So things are very sensitive. Be careful. And if you have not given immunization, anything, that those kind of things, please give the immunizations, regular immunizations, so that it will boost your immunity and they can sustain whatever. It shouldn't happen, but it shouldn't come in the life of any of the kids. So this is thing. And with respect to kids, children, you know, all children are a gift of the God. They are the replica of divinity. So we have, Jawaharlal says, the children are buds in the garden. We have to sensitively, lovingly nurture them. They are the tomorrow citizens. And the proper education only can make the best citizens of the country. So therefore, we are the parents, we are very responsible. There is a responsibility on us. So we cannot blame if children do anything wrong, as Benke sir said. So we should not blame anybody. If child is not doing thing, so we should be blamed. It is our responsibility. We are the first gurus. School is the next. Right? So therefore, it is our duty. Our duty. You know how innocent they are? This is a sense of innocence. That is innocent world, we can say. So they don't know. Because the child which is going to kids first LKG or UKG, it doesn't know anything. It is completely blank. It doesn't know good or bad, black or white, right or wrong. Just keep on giggling, squealing, jumping, laughing. Keep on doing all kinds of things. But it is we parents who teach them, we narrow its mentality. We teach this is not the right thing, this is not good thing. We teach them jealous kind of things, not so many things. So this is we are the responsible. Therefore, think in a broader sense and develop our, it is our responsibility to give proper guidances, proper etiquettes, teach proper social behaviors, and at least to spend 1 hour at least with our kids. Whatever the problems, our problems are, whether it is an economic problem, psychological problem, or health related issue, financial issue, but at least we should be able to spend 1 hour with our kids. Start giggling like them. Start feeling like them. What is there in it? In fact, it will boost our immune system. We are not only entertaining the kid, but we are also boosting our immunities, inner immunities by involving ourselves with the kids. So this is how we have so many things we have to do and we have to be prepared. And this the initiative taken by the Jesuits, St. Paul's, is definitely it's going to make a success. And coming to the principles and values that is maintained by St. Paul Jesuits and the curriculum that is given by the ICSE syllabus is going to excel and it's going to make headway in the not only national level, in the international level. So with this, I don't take much time because it's already too late. So I wish all the success to the institution and also I wish all the kids and their parents to have better future and better education. Thank you. Thank you.
He who plants a tree
plants a hope. I request our chief guest, Sri Anil Benke, MLA, along with the other dignitaries on the dais, to kindly come forward and plant a sapling to commemorate the inauguration of St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE.
Years of Ignatius conversion after the cannonball hit him. From 20th May 2021 to 31st July 2022, the Society of Jesus and the entire Ignatian family are celebrating an important Ignatian year. That event changed the course of his life. It led to the foundation of the Society of Jesus. Jesus, which in turn provoked dramatic changes in the church and in the history of the Catholicism. On this occasion, for the first time, a joint venture of the St. Paul's High School, St. Paul's Pre-University College, St. Paul's Jesuit ICSE School, Expolites and the Jesuit House together dedicate this song to all the Jesuits worldwide and to you, parents, who are our collaborators in this Jesuit venture. And we will strive to do our best for the greater glory of God. I would like to thank first the media team who has been behind this whole project of 31 days and will continue in this Ignatian year. I congratulate few with their names, Sir Deepak, Sir Borges, Sir Asif, Teacher Bharti, Teacher Vidhi, Teacher Janak, Mr. Salim, Mr. Srihas, Mr. Vishal, who is part of this media team. I also want to thank Father Savio, Father Sebi, and Father Ronnie, and Father Stephen, who have been continuously motivating all of them in promoting this song and this event. If you see today itself in the morning at around 8:30, we got 1,000 subscribers for our YouTube channel. In the same way, we have an Instagram channel, a Twitter channel, and also Facebook page. I request each one of you all to subscribe, like, and share. Okay, that's a normal thing that goes around. And I would like to now start the video by saying we are not only men and women for others, we are human for others.
it takes a U-turn, it's always never the same. A moment of change in a life of a saint that brought a plenty of fame. 500 ago, never would one conceive a cannonball that set the world on fire. Through a heart of Loyola, never would one conceive your glorious victory, sire. Saint Ignatius, our patron, you're the one we always see. Lord, we wanna lift your name, also enlighten your faith. Saint Ignatius, our patron, you're the one we always see. Ha, 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 you're the one we always see. Ha, ha.
Especially the composers, the lyrics was written by a Jesuit, Brother Ashwin Fernandez, who's here himself. The song, the female voice was put by the PU College. The main voice, the composer, was an ex-polite, a polite altogether. Yes, and I would say thank you to all the teachers who have been supportive in this venture. Thank you.
The evening is lovely, dark and deep, but we have promises to keep. Miles to go before we sleep, and miles to go before we sleep. Let's mark the end of this memorable function with a vote of thanks proposed by Teacher Gambetta De Mello.
At times, our own light goes out and is rekindled by a spark from another person. Each of us has a cause to think with deep gratitude of those who have lit the flame within us. I begin with thanking our Almighty for giving us such a wonderful day and also for guiding us to begin a new venture. For starting St. Paul's Jesuit School, ICSE. My heartfelt gratitude to our chief guest, Sri Anil Benke, MLA, Belagavi North, for gracing this occasion with his presence. A special thank you to all the dignitaries and also all the guests for today's inaugural ceremony. Thanks to all those precious hands which have helped us to begin this new venture. My sincere gratitude to all our staff members, both teaching and non-teaching, for it is they who have made this occasion a memorable one. I would like to end by quoting the words of Saint Ignatius of Loyola: "Pray as if God will take care of all, act as if all is up to you." Thanking you, and God bless you all.